Hello friends, subscribe to our channel GDC and press the bell icon for more updates.
Hello friends, today I am going to discuss some basic point of the GABA receptor. As we know, there is a neurotransmitter that is named as GABA. GABA neurotransmitter is inhibitory in nature. GABA neurotransmitter is inhibitory in nature, and the GABA neurotransmitter act in their two receptor. First receptor is known as GABA A, while second receptor is known as GABA B. And GABA A receptor is ligand gated ion channel, while GABA B receptor is G protein coupled receptor. So, ligand gated ion channel, I am going to here discuss only GABA A basically. So, GABA A is a ligand gated ion channel, and the ion which is responsible for the action of GABA by the GABA A receptor is chloride ion. Mainly, chloride ion act in the GABA A receptor. Here, GABA A receptor is basically pentameric in nature. Pentameric. That means it have 5 points. That is 5 mer pentameric. Here is alpha, beta, gamma. That is 5. That means pentameric and have 3 subunits. And these 3 subunits are alpha, beta and gamma. That means only 3 subunits make pentameric structure. That is the overview of the GABA A receptor. If we see it from the side, then side view is like this. This is the ion channel that by which chloride ion move. This is gamma subunit, this is beta subunit and this is alpha subunit. 2 alpha subunit, 2 beta subunit and 1 gamma subunit. Here is the different binding site. So first binding site is there for the GABA. GABA have a binding site in the beta subunit. Both beta subunit have a binding site for the GABA. While between the alpha and beta, here alpha and beta interface, there is a binding site for the barbiturate. Barbiturate bind at the alpha beta interface, while in the alpha gamma interface there is a binding site known as benzodiazepine binding site. So here 3 points covered. Where gamma binds? Gamma binds in the beta subunit. Where barbiturate binds? Barbiturate bind in the alpha beta interface, while benzodiazepine bind in the alpha gamma interface. So how it works? When GABA releases from the neurons, GABAergic neurons, it act in the beta subunit. So I'll flow diagrammatic right here for your easy understanding. First point, GABA bind in GABA A receptor. GABA bind in GABA A receptor. So what will happen by the binding of GABA A in the GABA receptor? After binding, this movement of chloride ion increases. That means the conductance from the outside to inside of the chloride ion increases. That means increase conductance of chloride ion. That means conductance of chloride ion increases. After this conductance, what will happen? As we know, wherever chloride ion conductance increases, that will lead hyperpolarization. So after the chloride ion conductance, what will happen? hyperpolarization. And this hyperpolarization will further induce CNS depression, that is inhibitory in nature. I have firstly introduced that GABA is inhibitory in nature, and that inhibitory in nature is due to the CNS depression by the hyperpolarization, that is increased conductance of chloride ion. So GABA will bind to the GABA receptor, that will increase the conductance of chloride ion, and that will lead to hyperpolarization, and by the hyperpolarization CNS depression will lead. This is the basic point about the GABA A receptor. Means GABA A receptor have three suffix binding sites for the GABA, for the barbiturate, for the benzodiazepine. And that is pentavalent in nature. Here have three subunits, alpha, beta and gamma, and the mode of action of GABA.